Hi, I'm going to tell you what to expect when you get a urodynamics test. This is a test that many urologists will order before they will do a bladder surgery or to evaluate what is going on with abnormal bladder function. It is a really fantastic test that gives us so much precise information about the bladder and can help lead to a diagnosis and point the way to the solution for your bladder problem. So, the patients that we will often order this test on are patients with a leaky bladder or a bladder that doesn't work well, or occasionally a very overactive bladder. And it's often done when we're thinking about surgery for prolapse, for leakage. If the patient's coming in, they've had a history of surgery and they're having a lot of issues, this will help determine if there is some blockage from the surgery that they had. It's also used quite a bit. We use it quite a bit in our patients with what's called neurogenic bladder, which is abnormal bladder function due to a neurological disease, such as multiple sclerosis, spinal cord injury, closed head injury, or stroke. So, urodynamics. As you can tell by the name, it is a dynamic test of the urinary tract of the bladder. So, it's going to give very precise measurements on the pressures in the bladder, the flow rate of the urine, the emptying pressures, the leak point pressure, and the amount of urine left inside the bladder. Now, I will admit, and I tell my patients, it's an awkward test. I wouldn't call it painful, but it can be uncomfortable, and it's just sort of awkward. You're sitting on a chair that can kind of go up and down. You're sitting in a seated position, so you're not laying down in a lithotomy position, except in rare situations. You're seated, and it does involve some catheters and monitors. So let's first talk about what do you need to do to prepare for your urodynamics test. One of the first things that we're going to want you to do is to do a bladder diary at home and get some very good information for us about how much fluid that you're taking in, how often you're going to the bathroom. We give you a what's called a hat that you can put in your toilet so you can measure how much urine is coming out, and then keep in track of how much you're leaking. Now, I know it's hard to know exactly how much you're leaking, so we just kind of do it on a scale of 1 to 3. So 1 would be a few drops. 3 would be a flood filling up a heavy pad, and 2 would be somewhere in between. So you just kind of estimate how much you're leaking, how severe it is, and then what you were doing when you leaked. That's very important to know. Was it a cough, a sneeze, exercising, washing your hands, getting home to trying to get in the door and the bladder just empties? What was it that caused the bladder to empty? And we look at all that. We calculate how much you took in, how much you put out. It's also very important to notice how much you put out during the day versus at night. That's very important information for us. So we do ask for you to do that homework for us. 48 hours is great. That's hard though. 24 hours is usually more realistic. You do need to stay in your home so you can measure every time you go to the bathroom. And you just drink whatever you normally would drink. You don't have to drink extra water or really push the amount of water that you're drinking. We just want you to drink your normal intake, whether it's soda, beer, alcohol, tea, coffee, Crystal Light, whatever it is that you normally ingest. We want to see what your normal day would be like. Okay, so that's your homework. Your other homework to prepare is to shave or trim the hair around your vagina. So if there's a lot of hair down there, it makes it very hard for the catheters to stay in. We do use a little bit of tape on the inner thigh to hold things in, and if there's hair there, that can make it difficult for everything to stay in place. So you want to trim. If you have any signs of infection, such as burning, frequency, overactive bladder, blood in the urine, we want to know about it because that may necessitate rescheduling the test. We don't want to do this test when you're infected. It's not going to be comfortable for you, and we're not going to get very good results. So that's the prep. Bowel movements, it's great if you can have a bowel movement before the test. But we really don't want you to try to take laxatives or force a bowel movement, because what happens is when you come into the test, your colon will be a little irritated, and then you could have a bowel movement during the test, which would make it a much longer test, take longer to get the results, and could interfere with getting good results. Okay, so what happens when you actually come in for your appointment? So we want you to drink liberally up to the test, but stop about 30 minutes before. So you're not making a ton of urine during the test. Your body's always making urine constantly. It's always filtering. So you're going to be making some urine during the test, but we don't want you to be really pouring it out, because that will skew the results a little bit. So stop drinking 30 minutes before the test. Come in with a full bladder. Don't forget. So don't walk into the building and go to the public restroom before you get here. We need you to come in and urinate here. We're going to have you, we're going to get a urine specimen, and we're going to see, make sure there's no infection before we get started. Okay, now you're going to go into the room. You're going to, just like any pelvic exam, pelvic study, you're going to take off your bottoms. You'll have a drape across your lap to try to keep it somewhat modest, although it's hard with this test because we are just getting right up in there. And then what we're going to do is put in a tiny catheter. I don't really have an example here, but tiny. It's way smaller than the opening of your bladder. And it's going to go inside. And on that catheter, it has pressure transducers. And we can also fill your bladder with water. So we're going to put that in and drain your bladder out. Start out at empty. We're also going to put another small catheter in your rectum. Now, I know that sounds really uncomfortable, but it's tiny. You know, it's kind of, you know, it feels weird, but it's not terrible. It's really small. So we put that in there, and that also has a pressure transducer on it, so it can measure your abdominal pressure. And then the third thing that we put on is some little pads. They're little sticky pads that are transducers that can really see what's going on with the pelvic floor muscles as you're urinating. Are your muscles relaxing normally? Are they tensing? What's happening? Are they relaxing and tensing at the right time? And so we put those on the buttock area, kind of right near the vagina, but more towards the back. Okay, so that's the setup. And then we're going to get started. And we're going to slowly fill your bladder with water, sterile water. And while we're filling, we're going to be measuring. We're going to be measuring the pressures and measuring how well your bladder can accommodate the urine, or excuse me, the water, and hopefully simulate what's going on with your bladder in real life. Now, as we're going along, we want to hear from you when you start to notice your bladder getting full, when you notice it getting quite full, like you might want to look for a bathroom, when you notice it getting very full, like you're going to pull over from a trip to go to the bathroom, and when it's urgent, I have to go to the bathroom right now. So we want you to give us, and we'll be asking you, but we want you to give us that feedback. And those are very important markers. Some people's bladders, they don't feel that they're getting full until they're super full. And some people think they're really full and they don't really have much in their bladder. So that's real important for us to know. Okay, so after we do that, then once you feel like I have to go to the bathroom, then we want you to just go. We want you to urinate. If there's time, we'll step out if you feel more comfortable in private. But the main thing is just to let it go. Because as soon as you start thinking about it too much and you inhibit the flow, it interferes with the test results. So you have to kind of get your mindset ready, like, I'm just going to let it go. Now, I say that, but it's hard. When someone's in the room with you, it's really hard to just let it flow. So we understand if it's your bladder's being shy, we have several tricks that we can do, and we'll step out, give you privacy to try to let it go. So let's say that your bladder is being shy. You feel the urge to go. So we'll step out. We have a little bell. So you let it flow out, and then you ring the bell when you're done. And when we come back in, we're going to measure and see what is left in your bladder. So we'll drain out the catheter and see how much is left behind, how well you emptied your bladder, how completely. And that's the test. Now, you may need a double test. So I order that a lot on my patients because I see a lot of prolapse patients. Prolapse patients have their bladders dropping down, and it's dropping down to the point where it's potentially interfering with their ability to empty their bladder. And in preparation for surgical repair, we'll do another run similar to the first run, but we'll put some support in their vagina to hold the bladder in place. It's called a pessary. It's like a little donut that we put inside there, and it just holds the bladder up so that then we can see, hopefully replicate, what's going to happen with the bladder after I do my lift and see if there's going to be any potential issues that I can fix all at the same surgery. The goal is to get everything figured out, everything predictable, so that when I go in and do surgery, I can get everything fixed all at the same time. And that's it. So then after you go through that, then we take everything out and you're good to go. We'll give you a little antibiotic. We have some antibiotics here that we'll give to prevent infection. We want you to go home and drink a lot of water and give yourself a treat, because you just had one of the craziest tests in medicine. But it's a really, really useful test. It's very helpful. It gives us a lot of information, and it really helps give precision to our treatment and our surgery. I hope that helps. If you have any questions in the comments, please let me know down below. I'd love to answer your questions. Have a great day.